Hey guys, Derek here. We're gonna take a look at the Summer Game Fest kickoff, whatever that is. Didn't even know it was kicking off today. I guess it's technically not E3, I suppose. So I guess they have their own starting time. We're gonna see what Doritos Pope Jeff has for us. Not really sure what they're showing off here. I know a lot of the big publishers have their days set in for around the E3 time, just in the weekend and into next week. So what's coming up here? Not entirely sure, but then again, there are publishers missing from E3, so I guess we'll see them here, maybe? Anyway, here comes two. Ah, now hang on, more stuff. Some viewers may find me offensive. Entirely possible. The Cube.
I told you we'd start right on time. Hello, everyone
We
around the
didn't,
world,
though. You're
and
like
welcome
2 minutes
to
late.
Summer Game Fest kickoff live, presented by Prime Gaming.
My
I'm
watch says
Jeff Keighley, and
7:01.
Buck, we have planned for the end game. That is all I'm allowed to tell you right now. This is just the start of a big Summer
They
Game
drop
Fest
Elden
weekend of
Ring
news and
during
major
this. That'll
plans,
be
including
insane.
lots of the next great adventure from Gearbox and 2K.
Borderlands, I mean Wonderlands. Yes, definitely. They're definitely different. All right, I'm prepared, I guess. Dragons, right? Are they trying to do an Elden Ring thing and then just
Fate.
make it Borderlands instead?
It soars on the wind. It rises from the grave.
Does it?
It stalks the ocean floor.
Citation needed?
You cannot hide from fate.
He's got really good ventilation in that blacksmith, though.
But you can make your own.
When did he put bullets into that gun? While he was forging it? That seems unlikely. Oh, for the love of God. Oh, we're having buffering issues. But Stallion is a Borderlands reference for anyone who is unfamiliar. Wonderlands, yeah, this had been leaked already. So it's just Borderlands. Okay. Anyway, I'm not sure how you can like preface it by saying
Tiny Tina's
all of
Wonderland
these
is
great
official,
people
and joining
starring
us now is
in
Tiny
it
Tina herself.
and not showing any actual
What's up,
gameplay,
baby? How you doing?
but I guess you don't need to
Here.
because
So I think the big question everyone's
it's
gonna have
just
is like,
gonna be
what is
Borderlands
Wonderland?
again.
What can you tell us about it?
It's a great question.
Yeah.
It's a high fantasy take on a looter shooter, as you saw. And if you're a fan of
Did we
Borderlands,
see
you'll
that?
probably
We just saw a
recognize
CG thing.
some fantasy elements inspired by Assault on Dragon Keep, which was the Borderlands 2 DLC that was beloved by the devs. And so this kind of inspired Wonderlands.
Now, I think the elephant in the room is this a Borderlands game? Is it not? How does it relate?
So it actually isn't. It's its own standalone game.
Yeah, sure. It's still a looter
people that
shooter,
love
though.
Borderlands are going to find lots of elements to love about Wonderlands, but it's its own thing. Tiny Tina's got her own thing going on now. So it's got its own mechanics. There's spell casting. You can
That's
customize
just
your character
abilities.
this time, which is
You
super
could do that
exciting.
anyway.
And yeah, so
you
if
could
you
do that
love
in
Borderlands,
Borderlands.
you're gonna find stuff to love in this.
Well, I
And
mean,
if you've
define
never played a Borderlands
customizing,
game,
I
this is a great place
suppose.
to start.
Okay, well, Tiny Tina
If
gets
you've
her
never
own
played a
game,
Borderlands
which is
game,
fantastic.
the
What is
best place to
her
start is
role
not a
role while
Borderlands
you get
game.
her own game?
So she is your bunker master.
Okay.
She is kind of guiding the narrative and changing it on a dime if she wants. And she's just taking your cast of characters, which is an amazing cast, through this wacky world, and she's taking you on an adventure to defeat the Dragon Lord.
And
who is that? I don't know. You'll have to play.
And I wonder who plays the Dragon Lord, because you've got quite the voice cast, including you in this, which
oh.
is awesome. So
yeah.
feels
Thank
like
you.
Such a big experience. So this was a bit of a tease,
How would we
announcing
know?
It's out
There's
there.
no gameplay yet.
When will we find out more about this game?
Hopefully this summer,
yes.
And you can find out a lot more at playwonderlands.com if you'd like.
Okay.
But yeah, just stay tuned for updates.
All right, coming early 2020.
Never. You can't tell me what to do.
Look forward to next year. Ash, thank you so much for joining us in person.
Thanks for having me.
I really appreciate it. And we'll see more later this summer on that game. All right, well,
now go get yourself tested.
Another brand new game announcement. This one you probably are not expecting. A classic 90s franchise is coming back to life as a grid-based tactical strategy title for Steam on PC. This is an insanely fun trailer.
I have heard this. I think I've heard some stuff about this. World premiere. Guess I have to say it. Metal Slug. Metal Slug as a tactics shooter? That's interesting. I mean, any kind of change to the franchise would be interesting, because it's been long enough. And there have been newer installments of Metal Slug. Versus how much appetite is there for like the old school version of Metal Slug? This might be interesting enough. I know a lot of people were really annoyed with the character change, or not character change, but the design change for a lot of these characters. They're a little more attractive now. I saw .emu are attached, so it'll probably be really good. Do you know what they're doing? Metal Slug Tactics says it there at the bottom if you can't read it. My face might be in the way. I forgot to assign a button to turn my face off, so you're stuck with my face for this whole video, sorry. Yeah, interesting.
Okay, we have another big announcement for you from a surprise guest, but it's well past 3 a.m. their time, so don't worry, we chatted earlier,
Japan, so.
And I'm very excited
not me,
to share
unfortunately.
With you right now. Hello, mystery guest.
Hello.
Mr. Kojima,
of
it is
course.
So good to see
best
you.
Friends
thank you for joining
that everyone
us,
believes. Everyone believes
Tokyo.
They're best friends.
First of all, I just want to ask, how are you doing? How are you feeling? How are things right now over
wow,
there in
Jeff.
Japan?
東京ではですね、また非常事態宣言というのが出てて、まあ、ちょっとコロナの、患者数が増えつつあると。で、ワクチンをそろそろ打ち出そうとしている、そういう感じですね。
Well, we certainly hope that you're going to get your vaccine soon.
Jeff, you had no idea what he said.
Let me ask you, as a creator, how has this past year impacted you?
まあ今まで
Oh, it's fucking sucked, Jeff, let me tell you.
今自分がいる世界を見て、で地続きで5年後、10年後、20年後どうなるかっていうのを考えながら、そこにエンターテインメントを加えていって、まあ、作ってたのが結構その10年後、20年後に当たってたりっていうのがあったんですけど、今回の DS に関してはもう発売直後になったので、ちょっと
talking about, I don't know if you guys could read the subtitles, he's talking about how Death Stranding was a little too close to how COVID lockdown stuff went about. And it was, like, very prescient.
なんで今回のコロナの中で、この先をどう作るかっていうのはいろいろ考えましたね。他のクリエイターも多分大きく考えていると思います。911の時と同じような感じだと思います、ね。これからエンタメをどういうふうに切り取っていくかっていうのはやっぱり大きな課題ではありますね。
Well, I know we are all very curious about what the next era of Hideo Kojima Entertainment is going to be. I don't know how much you can say, but can you give us any sense of kind of where your mind's at right now, what you're thinking about, some of the themes or the ideas?
これ言えないですか。今までのような こう一歩一歩進むものじゃないんですよね。やっぱりその911の時もそうですけど、このコロナでガラリとあらゆるものが変わっていく、ものすごいスピードで変わっていくんで、
so, do you have a trailer?
でそこでエンターテインメントが遅れを取ってしまうとダメなんで、それをどうするかというその予測ですね。まあ、全くこう宇宙人が攻めてくるとか、そういうゲームであれば、コロナ禍でも関係ないんでしょうけど、やっぱりこう、社会性の基盤を持ったエンターテインメントっていうのを作りたいですし、皆さんに起こりつつあることをエンターテインメントの中でちょっとこう紹介したいというのもあるので、今後の
世の中でどちらの方向に向かってい
くかっていうのが今まで以上にすごく急激に変わっていっているので、そこを間違えないように作るというか、そこはすごく神経質になってます今。
All right, fair enough. I tried. Well, Mr. Kojima, honestly, I really do appreciate you making the time to stop by and just say hello to everyone. We miss you, and we can't wait to see what you're working on next. So, thank you.
Jeff, one more thing.
Oh no, he's doing the Apple thing. Oh, it's published by PlayStation. Death Stranding 2, or just Death Stranding DLC? Death Stranding Last for Us. Last of Us, something or other. That's very Metal Gear Solid. This, I mean, the music is very Metal Gear Solid. Okay, I only said like Last of Us because of what I saw on the walls, but I can see now it's just like limestone. It's not funguses. What is this? Who's in the box? What is going on? The orange box thing was a Metal Gear Solid thing? That's what the box was? That's what was labeled on the box? And hiding out in a box is obviously a big Metal Gear thing. Sam, they're gonna know you turfed out the box because all the oranges are on the ground. Help. What's the plan, Sam? Gotta put it over your head. Aww. Okay. Will it have Metal Gear Solid stuff on us?
There you have it. Death Stranding Director's Cut finally confirmed. I hope I make it into the Director's Cut. I'm told the full reveal is just weeks away.
He was one of the pod people.
Right, next, here now to perform Glider from the upcoming open world game Sable by Raw Fury and Shedworks.
I am actually looking forward to Sable. Is it Amurice? Well, I'll have to cut this part out because copyright. So we'll be back in a minute.
So beautiful.
And we're back. It was actually a really good song, and there was Sable gameplay as well, so there's a little
more about this amazing game.
Not great, I have to cut it out, but
game showcase,
anyway.
That is to the world of Lost Ark from Smilegate RPG and Amazon Games.
Amazon Games. Is it Lost Ark or Lost Ark? So, Diablo?
A lost ark.
Well, that answers that.
But a myth. A relic from a half-remembered chain war.
Oh yeah, that thing. The war about the chains.
Now, our world has been torn once again. The demons have returned.
Them demons, they're always coming back. I like this music choice. What is the gameplay, Diablo? Kyle, thank you. That's all I wanted to know. He did say it was an MMO though, right? Yeah, not liking this music choice. They did the same thing for Godfall, just put me off it entirely. Just doesn't gel with the world they're building here. I don't know. Oh no, not genticles.
Out of hope, we turn to myths to prove that not all is lost.
Looks like it's PC only anyway.
Sometimes when you play a game, there's that one thing in your inventory which turned out to be far more useful than you first realized. That's kind of like Prime Gaming. If you're an Amazon Prime member...
Oh god, it's an ad. Cut it.
Okay, right now I'm honored to be joined by...
Oh god, not Call of Duty. Right, we're going to keep cutting.
Johanna, it's joined Activision to run Call of Duty Esports, and we're going to talk a little bit now about what is the... World Series of Warzone.
No, we're not. I'm cutting this too.
It won multiple awards at the Game Awards, and Among Us just keeps going. Now it's time to hear from Inner Sloth on what's coming next.
More Among Us, I imagine. Yep, more Among Us. Oh, an official hide and seek mode? There was an unofficial version. It was like a community-led thing, but they're gonna make it an official thing? That's pretty good. Okay. Chivos? Everybody loves Chivos. The new roles and unofficial hide and seek will probably be good for that.
Lots of fun ahead. And speaking of Among Us, last year you may remember the very rare Jeff Keighley mask was available as a Twitch drop around the Game Awards, never to be seen again. In fact,
except
I often
right
hear on
now.
Twitter from people who get booted from games with the mask because folks think they're hacked. Well,
no, they don't. They just don't want to look at your face, Jeff.
The mask is back. Just head to Twitch, connect your account, and watch 15 minutes or more of Kickoff Live to get your very own Jeff Keighley mask.
Oh, 15
Once
minutes,
again,
Jeff.
It goes back into the vault.
Could you not get any better than that?
I don't know what's going on. All right. Speaking of independent developers, now I'm very happy to welcome to Summer Game Fest the head of indies at PlayStation, a legend in his own right who has some exciting things to share, Shuhei Yoshida. Hi, Shu.
Yosp.
Thanks, Jeff. Hi everyone, I'm Shuhei Yoshida,
Hi, Shu.
Head of PlayStation.
Could you come back to head
what
PlayStation
I love about
in general?
These independent developers are the new and unexpected games that they create, which allows us to offer an array of unique experiences for players. In my role at Sony, it's very exciting to get to meet with these talented studios, which sometimes can be one person or a small group of friends, to help nurture the ideas and bring them to the PlayStation fans. One example is from Finji, who has been working with Greg Lobanov, the developer of Wondersong, to publish their new game, Chicory, A Colorful Tale. Chicory released today and gives players a chance
today?
To experience a coloring book-style world where players use their painting powers to explore, solve puzzles, make friends, and draw on anything.
I have been interested in the game purely because of the dog.
On PlayStation 4 or PlayStation 5 after the show. As a huge Soulsborne games fan, I totally enjoyed the beautiful 2D action adventure Salt and Sanctuary a few years ago.
Yeah, that was an interesting game.
The developer Ska Studios has been hard at work on a new title, which I'm proud to present to you, Salt and Sacrifice.
Oh. No Sanctuary anymore, just Sacrifice.
Our sins will catch up with us.
Giant enemy crabs.
Always.
Big goat dude. Squish. Obliterated.
I was given a second chance. I spoke the words. I drank the mage bane.
Oh, well, that was a mistake. Surely the word bane must have given it away, no?
I live now only to hunt mages.
Sure, you should get them to drink the mage bane, no?
I am a marked inquisitor. There aren't many of us.
But together, we will tame the chaos.
Salt and sacrifice. What I've seen of the game, the original game, looked really good. I could never get into it just because of the animation style. I just didn't like it.
Heart Machine game, Solar Ash, which is coming to PlayStation later this year.
Is this the game I think it is? Is this the Heart Machine game? Yeah, okay. This game looks really good. To me, anyway. Hey, what's up? Get your ass down here. How you doing? There's a lot of I thought it at the launch trailer. There's a good bit of Shadow of the Colossus to this game. A speedy Shadow of the Colossus. Ow! I was taking you for a ride, dude.
That looks so great. Can't wait to see it later this year. Now, this week there is a ton of video game news, but there's also a big game launching across console and PC, Chivalry 2, which brings 64-player multiplayer.
Oh, you mean the troll game, right?
Sledgehammers, swords, axes, you name it, and it comes from Torn Banner Studios in my hometown,
Anti-material
Toronto,
rifle?
Canada.
It's probably not.
Here's
in
a
the
look
game.
At the launch trailer for Chivalry 2, which you can play right now.
Right now, if you can get into a game.
Radio, women.
Who? Who are we killing?
There comes a time when a moment.
Dude, stop smacking your shield. You need that. Everybody gets killed by archers. See? The knights aren't doing shit. The archers do everything. Medieval warfare. Well, you don't have a weapon now. Good job, idiot. How did you slash through plate mail, Chief?
For Agatha!
Who?
Agatha!
Well, that guy's dead. Like, whoever plays the archer should just win all the time. I don't think anyone, I don't think a knight would shout chivalry on the battlefield somehow. Anyway.
This month, Valorant from Riot celebrated its 1 year anniversary.
Skip.
Starting next Monday, June 14th,
we've had enough of Riot on this show. Riot Games.
When I was a kid, the simulation games of Peter Molyneux were some of my favorites. Adding that extra salt on the fries in the theme park to increase your drink sales was so devilish. Well, many of the team members behind those sim games went on to create 2 Point Studios and 2 Point Hospital. Well,
today, it's a 2 Point University.
To share the first trailer for their next 2 Point simulation, 2 Point Campus.
Campus, whatever. This was leaked a while ago.
That first sight of the school gates, the scent of a leather-bound book, the faint clatter of knights jousting. Well, I can't say I remember that part, though it wasn't like this in my day. You see, campuses are forever changing. Nowadays, education has to be fun. It can't be all work and no play, and quite right too. Apparently, the results speak for themselves. Academia has never been more appealing, more dynamic, more whatever this is. Today's campus is a place to live and a place to learn. Finely crafted by the sharpest minds that money can buy. Though sometimes
he didn't have a lot of money.
Still can't get the staff. Yes, these days it really does feel as though anything is possible. Point Campus. Class is in session 2022.
Cool. 2 Point Hospital is a good game, so I have no reason to believe 2 Point Campus will be a good game.
This year I am thrilled to have Netflix as a part of Summer Games.
God damn fucking ads again.
Incredible more game added to the mix, and for that we go to Todd Hollinshead from Saber. Todd, how you doing?
I'm great, Jeff. Thank you for the intro there. I'm really excited to have this little last edition, which is that Saber and Prime Matter are working together on a new game in the Painkiller franchise.
Right.
All right, very cool.
Was that that was it?
Next up, last year, a new Swedish company named Shark Mob released a teaser for their first unnamed multiplayer project in the Vampire the Masquerade universe. Tonight, we're putting
Why?
A name
Why do you do this
first
to me?
Game with a brand new world premiere trailer.
Why do you make multiplayer games? Stop doing it. Quit it. Especially since Bloodlines 2 is probably never gonna come out.
For centuries we have lived in secrecy among you, maintaining the masquerade.
I mean, it's not that secret. It's just no one's gonna say anything. We're just gonna continue to do that? Aren't they vampires? The fuck are guns gonna do? Why is it a shooter? Why? Why is it a shooter? Why is it a shooter? Why? Why? Why did it have to be a shooter? Why did it have to be multiplayer? Never mind that.
Game, and we actually won't have to wait long. You can sign up now for the bloodhunt.com is where you go for the closed alpha.
I'm PC good. Test. Thanks, Jeff.
Available on July 2nd. Bloodhunt will be released later this year. Next, the latest horror game series from the creators of Until Dawn continues with the House of Ashes, part of the Dark Pictures anthology. This third game features American and Iraqi soldiers stranded in a cursed temple. Here's the story trailer with the exclusive reveal of the monsters lurking in the depths.
I don't think we want to see the monsters, right? That's kind of the whole point of these haunted house monster type things. You're not supposed to see the monster. Your imagination is always much, much worse.
An ancient horror has awoken from its slumber and is hungry for blood.
Aren't they always?
Shall we see how many have fallen into shadow?
It's just like me when I wake up in the morning.
Satellite sweeps of the war zone have uncovered what appears to be an underground storage facility.
Some miscellaneous U.S. war.
Where chemical weapons are hidden, so we need to move
citation
fast.
Needed.
Descend into the unknown alone is extremely brave.
Men out, hold fire.
Or extremely foolish.
We're gonna sigh out.
And they're often one and the same.
Or will it be a case of each man for himself?
Down, get down! They're up on the ridge! Return fire!
You teeter on the edge of an abyss.
An abyss?
Your survival depends on the choices.
Ow, he's dead.
They will be as a compass, guiding you through the unknown.
We're on God's green earth that we land.
What nightmare have these luckless souls fallen into?
You keep lookout.
Is it gonna turn out that one of them bumped their head when they landed, and it's all a dream?
One, their lights will be snuffed out. Unless you can find the means to save them.
Half the fun of this game is figuring out who's the biggest asshole and then making sure they die.
Will you find the path to salvation? Or be lost in the darkness? Forever.
The House of Asses. So they didn't reveal the monster. Never mind. Spoke too soon. Sure looks like a vampire though, so that's interesting. Come on, really? And there's a fucking figurine of it and everything. Why does it have wings? If it lives underground?
One of the longest, most beloved JRPG franchises in the industry is the Tales of series. Well, the latest game arrived...
It's not where I thought he was going with that, but okay.
...and it brings the franchise into stunning 3D with Unreal Engine 4. Here's a world premiere look at the latest trailer with more information following in the coming weeks.
It was already in... The Tales games have been in 3D for ages. What is he talking about? What is he talking about?
Pretty fancy place they got here.
Harmony and coexistence between the Renans and the Danans.
I'm Dohilim Ilkaris. Should you need my skills on the battlefield, all I care for is maintaining peace.
I'm Captain Kisara of the Elder Menencia Guard.
Of course you are.
Flare the Malisha! From now on, when I fight to protect my dream.
Well, this crew just gets bigger and bigger.
Very Japanese.
The Renans. Seems the rumors you were running with them were true.
I don't think bullets work that way, but okay.
Been looking for you.
That's anime as shit, but okay.
Get the hell out of my realm. This is Tannin's realm, and
this is why you play Tales, really, for the super anime stuff. I just hope they keep the skits, that's all. Gonna need a bigger shield.
It's only just begun.
Yeah, this one's been put back a good few times, so hopefully they hit that release date. This one didn't even get a lead-in from Jeff. Yoff.
For Summer Game Fest, we have a special announcement for you.
Okay.
That the console version of Sky Children of the Light would arrive to Nintendo Switch on June 29th. And
got it.
Little Prince season would start soon after on July 6th.
Cool.
Enjoy the game.
Sure sounds like he was doing his contractually obligated PR.
One of the things I take great pleasure in is using a platform like this show to introduce you to new developers and studios with games that deserve the spotlight. That's definitely the case.
That's why you gave so much time to Call of Duty.
Swedish studio named Wishfully. Planet of Lana tells the story of a young girl and her loyal friend who embark on a mission through a colorful world that's designed to feel like a gouache watercolor painting come to life. Here's your first look at the Planet of Lana.
It's gouache, to Xbox and PC, Jeff. Gouache, not gouache. Well, that looks pretty. I'll probably be getting this. I'm a sucker for a good art style. Not even a good art style, like a different one. Chomp. That's not good. Looks like Jeff Bezos is coming back in. Should we move? I bet he's friendly.
What a beautiful artistic game.
Skip.
Now, speaking of Fall Guys, the time has come to reveal a brand new costume coming to the game.
The Jeff Keighley costume?
Legendary game franchise. Check it out.
Is this the Bomberman one? Because they showed that already. Near costume? They're not going to get me to play Fall Guys. I don't care if you do put a 2B costume in.
Games, a publisher, Prime Matter, so why not announce a developer too? And joining me now are Dave Anthony and Jason Blundell from the newly formed Deviation Games. We know you guys well from all your amazing work over the years at Treyarch and Call of Duty Black Ops, but what can we expect from your new studio, guys?
More shooters!
And look, Jason and I, we've been mates for donkey's years. And we're like an old married couple, Jeff. And we've been working together for decades. And we've worked on some huge franchises. You know the games, you know, they've done well. And but we thought, you know, when you're working on those franchises, the long established IPs, you're working within very, very tight constraints creatively about what you can do. So we thought, after all these years, you know, what if we deviated?
Yes.
So that's Deviation Games.
Okay.
So Jeff, just trust me, all bets are off. From
right.
day one, we got complete financial security to work with creative freedom and time, not just to make a brand new IP,
who bought you?
Which is what we're doing, but a groundbreaking new IP with innovation at its very core. And the team at Deviation Games, the culture we have is really, really simple. It's, there's no place for ego. It's the best idea that always wins, and that's Deviation Games.
But who decides it's the best idea?
big ideas from you guys as we would expect. Now, I know it's very early and there is nothing to show on the game today, but can you tell us a bit about what kind of game you're making? What can we expect?
It's a first-person shooter.
Right there, Jeff. Very early, but a lot of exciting stuff going on. So essentially, we spent the last year building the team, right? And so what we knew was we wanted to collect passionate, creative, collaborative people and bring them together kind of under one roof, and that's what Deviation Games
is. Really answering Jeff's question.
We don't have a show right now, but that collaboration, that imagination is going on, and we're going to have something that's going to, I think, leave an indelible mark in the industry when we come out.
All right. Well, with you guys involved, as I said, we're excited about it. There is one more piece of the puzzle, though, that you want to reveal today, and for that, let's take a look at this.
Cross Sony, yeah, I know. Somebody had to give them the money, so yeah, fair enough.
Okay, big news. The stage has changed. Blue of PlayStation, so you're partnering with PlayStation. What can you tell us about that partnership?
That's right, Jeff. And
they gave us so much money, Jeff. Oh my God.
From soup to nuts, this project is all about quality. And our team of
from soup to nuts
back in the studio, we're doing this for you. We are so proud.
So nervous.
And the partnership with Sony, it's very, very simple. I mean, God, just look at the track record of consistency, of high-quality games that they do. It's hit after hit. It's award after award. And now we've been part of this process and we see how they do things. Yeah. It's really clear how they're managing to accomplish that. So we couldn't be more proud to expand PlayStation's portfolio, yeah, which we're going to do in a very, very significant way.
I mean, let's just face it, right? Sony rocks.
They
get our kind of brand of crazy, so we're very happy with this partnership.
All right, so Deviation Games, PlayStation, brand new IP, a mega IP, it sounds like, coming in the future, and hopefully we'll see you guys again in the future to see more on what you're working on.
Thanks a lot, Jeff.
Awesome. All right, Dave, Jason, thank you very much, guys. All right, well, this year is the 30th anniversary of Sonic the Hedgehog, and later this month, we are honored to be premiering the full Sonic Symphony performance. Right now, here's the Philharmonic Orchestra in Prague performing the music of Sonic Unleashed.
We're gonna have to skip this too. Sonic Unleashed is a weird one to pick, but okay.
Who's ready for some Evil Dead? We announced this game last December at TGA, and now it's time for an extended look at the gameplay. To tell us more, let's turn it over to my friend, Tim Willits from Saber.
Not Bruce Campbell.
It's great to see you. Today, we have
Tim, really? Like a 1-4 Iron Man? Really?
We are excited to show you this.
And a Hellraiser, and a Fallout Boy, and...
Thank you.
Well, they did get Bruce Campbell. Good. No, they didn't. They got him free in the game.
Cyber friends. I'm Bruce Campbell. You know me as Ash Williams, the dude who saved the world from evil.
Yep,
I'm
that's
here
him.
To bring you the lowdown on the upcoming Evil Dead the Game. You and your friends will team up as classic Evil Dead heroes to live the nightmare. You'll use savage finishing moves or tear evil a new one. Or, if you're not into the whole save the world thing, we have another option.
What, become a deadite? Or just leave?
You can play as the vile Kandarian demon itself. But who would want to do that? He'd be a dick. With the power of possession in your arsenal, you'll scare those goody two-shoes to death. Literally, you can do that if you're a dick. Whether you choose the path of evil or righteousness, you'll be throwing down in places you've seen before. You'll collect pages of the Necronomicon, uncover Nobi's lost tapes, and track down other legendary artifacts. When you've grabbed enough, you'll use a spell to send the Kandarian son of a bitch back to the hellhole it came from. Soon, you'll experience the horror yourself, but for now, I'll leave you with this thought. It was no accident that Ash always wore
Brown pants.
Oh wow, that's a really bad aim. So it's a kind of asymmetrical 4v1 kind of thing. So there's a bit of the, what's the newer Resident Evil thing, team game, where you have one guy who can kind of take over the area. It's probably a champion character. Get what it's called now. Resident Evil 1. Overlord or something like that.
Okay, guys. Now it's time
to end
finale to the show. This is extremely special. Today, I am so deeply honored to be given the opportunity to share this next game.
Elden
it comes from one of our industry's most acclaimed developers and a previous Game of the Year winner at the Game Awards. I want to personally thank this developer for believing in my vision of Summer Game Fest as a new way to bring all of us together for a cross-industry showcase and kick off the summer in the right way. So, without further ado, please sit back and enjoy this truly spectacular world premiere.
Elden Ring.
It is finally time.
It's gotta be Elden Ring. If it's not Elden Ring, I'm very disappointed, Jeff. It's Elden Ring. Oh boy. Internet is gonna go fucking insane.
The Tarnished will soon return. Guided by grace once lost.
That's a big tree. Or a big mushroom, probably.
The Golden Order is broken to its core.
It's a bit Shadow of the Colossus at the moment. Mounted combat. Okay. There it is. He said it. He said the thing.
Emboldened by the flame of ambition, someone must extinguish thy flame.
That was a very Sekiro kind of fight too there.
And they will die.
What about me though? Will I die? Okay, they just decided to merge Artorias and Sif. There's co-op buddies. Okay, good. We are gonna die a lot. Fair enough. Oh no, I don't like that hand enemy. Oh god, and a release date too. Yeah, internet will go insane.
It actually happened. Elden Ring is coming, as you saw, January 21st, 2022 to next gen, current gen. It's so incredible, and I want to thank so much Miyazaki-san and the team at From for sharing that in-game look at Elden Ring. I hope you guys are happy. Oh my God, I'm free out of prison. All right. And that's going to do it for Summer Game Fest Kickoff Live. Thank you so much to all the developers who took part.
That was a good, finish.
Watching around the world, it means so much to me. Summer Game Fest continues all weekend with Netflix Geeked Week and Prime Matter tomorrow.
They have to call it that.
On Saturday, and Xbox and Bethesda on Sunday, Square Enix as well. Head to summergamefest.com for the full
Nintendo are also doing something, but really I guess they didn't get in on the Summer Game Fest. And we don't know what the fuck Sony are doing.
That I'm fully supportive of, and I'm very excited to see what they're doing anything for us as well. As for me, I'll see you again on August 25th for Gamescom Opening Night Live. And this December, I am so happy to say that the Game Awards will return as an in-person ceremony at the Microsoft Theater in Los Angeles. More details are coming later this summer.
Terms and conditions.
Thanks again
apply.
For being a part of Summer Game Fest. We will see you tomorrow for more. And stay tuned for the Day of the Devs with I Am 8-Bit and Double Fine right now. Good night, everybody.
All right, well, that's Summer Game Fest opening night. Elden Ring, obviously a big deal. I'm probably going to see a lot about that on the internet. Maybe there'll be more stuff. Interviews and all that kind of thing, we'll hear more about it. Don't know how much of this video I'm actually going to use. Guess we'll see. If you see a lot of cuts and a lot of jumps and stuff, you'll know why. We're not going to watch this, and that's actually really loud. So.
Hello, and welcome to Day of the Devs, a digital showcase of the best of independent games.
How do I turn it off? There. Okay. We'll just turn that off. Anyway, so that was Summer Game Fest kickoff. Mostly it was, here's a little bit of something, and then later on there'll be a bigger video for it. So this seemed like it was more of a table of contents for what's coming up on the weekend and then a couple of days afterwards. Name dropping the different events that are going to be happening on Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. Those were kind of the bigger names. There's nothing... I know Capcom are doing something as well. Nintendo are doing something too. They just probably aren't part of the Summer Game Fest. Maybe they are exclusive to E3 or whatever. I guess we'll find out. Anyway, let me know what you guys thought. I don't know if I'm going to even use this video or at all, or if I'm going to bundle it into a bigger video or whatever. We'll see. I guess you can tell me in the comments what I ended up doing. I don't know what I ended up doing. Anyway, goodbye, Tim Schafer. Bye-bye, and bye-bye, everybody else.